Hello everyone, Michael here from the Daily Note 2 YouTube channel, and welcome to another episode of Galaxy Note 2 Tips and Tricks Episode 23. Today I want to show you how to transfer files wirelessly from your Galaxy Note 2 to your computer, or vice versa, and I believe it offers a couple of advantages over transferring files through the USB cable. Maybe, for example, if the files aren't terribly big, you don't necessarily want to connect your USB cable each time because it is inconvenient, or maybe you just simply forgot the USB cable. Or if you are somebody like me, I really don't like the fact that I have to do these small charges and disconnect it, because when I want to charge, I like to charge from start to finish without interruptions. So one thing you'll need is you'll need to make sure that the Galaxy Note 2 and the computer that you want to connect this to are on the same local network. I'm going to assume that you have that connected already, so let's get started. First thing you'll need is an app called SwiFTP. You could call it SwiftP or SwiftFTP. I'm not exactly sure which name they chose, but that's how you spell it. And it used to be an app offered in the Google Play Store, but it is no longer. It is because the dev decided to pull it because he ran out of time answering emails, and it was a free app. But it is still available in the Google repository. So let's just go to downloads directly on here. Okay, downloads, and then you could just click on this file, 1.2.1.24, okay, and click on this link one more time, and it's going to start downloading. Okay, and it is a very small app. It finished downloading. Click on what it just downloaded and install it. Okay, and let's open it and put in a username. My name is Mike, so that's exactly what I'm going to put in. And then I'm going to put Mike1234 as the password, okay? And just remember the port number as 2121. And everything is good. Let's click on save. And let's start the FTP server. Now we're going to need to jump to the PC. So on your computer's web browser, Google search the term FileZilla, F-I-L-E-Z-I-L-L-A. And go to the download link under FileZilla, the free FTP solution. And as you can see, they have downloads for Windows, Linux, Mac OS X. And I have Windows, so I'm going to do download now for Windows. And I'm going to wait 5 seconds for this to happen. But after this downloads, go to your download folder where this file lands. Okay, the file transfer is done. I'm going to double click to install it. Okay, you can see that it has finished installing, so let's start the program by having this check mark on and clicking on finish. So let's go to the top left hand corner. You're going to see the small icon, and it's going to say open the site manager. Let's create a new site and type in Galaxy Note 2, and the first field is called host. The host is your IP address of your Galaxy Note 2, and it is conveniently provided to you on the Galaxy Note 2. Just copy these numbers, 192.168.0.11, that's mine. Your IP address is going to be slightly different than that. So I'm going to type in 192.168.0.11, and then as you remember, we kept the port at 2121 as long as you didn't change it. Put it port 2121. Okay, and then we're going to change the logon type. The logon type is going to be normal. And remember, I put in Mike as my username, Mike1234 as my password. Okay, and I'm going to click on connect. And as you can see, it connected to my Android. And right now we're looking at files on my Android device. And where your files are located, you can see that there's an SD card in here, but there's a better location that is more easier or more convenient for everything, and it's the storage folder. We just double clicked on that, and as you can see, this one says external SD card, and this one, SD card 0, is your internal card. So let's do a quick file copy in here. So let's go to the external SD card, and I'm going to the location where the phone stores my videos and photos when I take it with the camera. It's in the DCIM camera. Okay, and all the photos and videos that I have taken are in here. So let's just drag a couple. And this one is currently selected on my desktop, right? But you could drag it anywhere, whether it be a folder or even on your desktop outside of this application. So let's do that. And as you can see, it transfers the files very quickly. I'm getting about 4 megabytes a second, and that is all the speed I need to do these file transfers. And let's do it the other way. I'm going to copy these 5 files from my desktop and I'm going to drag it into my Android folder here. And as you can see, it just copied about 3.5 megs of files in relatively no time. So when you're done with the file transfer process, just go back to your Android and click on the stop button, and you could click on the back button a few times to exit out of there. Okay, and let's just do that process one more time. Now that we have everything set up, go to your Android when you want to copy a new file off the phone and hit SwiftP and click on start. Now go to your computer and go to the FileZilla app or program that you installed. And then when this opens up, there's a drop down menu right next to the manage sites icon that we clicked on previously, and click on Galaxy Note 2. And once again, we're connected, and we could go to that storage folder once again, and you could start transferring files in and out of your Galaxy device. And I just want to show you one more, nice tip. You could see that remote site, we went into the storage folder. Just do a copy there. Okay, and let's go back to your site manager there. And then we're going to click on advanced for the Galaxy Note 2 profile. And then under default remote directory, just do a paste. Okay, and click on OK. So once again, I'm going to start the FileZilla app, and when I hit that drop down and go to Galaxy Note 2, I could either choose external SD card or SD card, and it is literally very quick. So there you go. And once again, make sure you, when you're done, click on the stop on the FTP server and click on the back button. So that is the end of this episode, and I hope you got something out of it. As you can see, you could just set it up one time, and it may offer some great conveniences to you. So I set up a Twitter account today after putting it off for about a month. So I hope you come to my channel, go to my Twitter account, and follow. And as you can see, what I showed you today does not only apply for the Galaxy Note 2, but for all Android devices. So if you know somebody that could benefit from this information, you could share it by retweeting the tweet of this episode. So anyway, if you haven't been to my channel yet, please come by to my channel and check it out. I have about 90 videos on the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe, because I do create an episode a day so that you could get the most out of your brand new Samsung Galaxy Note 2. Once again, thank you for watching.